Dover, Delaware is a city with a fascinating history that dates back to the 17th century. It's one of the oldest cities in America and ranks highly in our book of top travel destinations in the country, especially if you're someone obsessed with the history of this great nation. As the second biggest city in the U.S. state of Delaware, Dover has a lot going for it. There's always something to do, see, or experience when visiting Dover. Join us as we take a tour of some of the best sites and destinations Dover has to offer. First State Heritage Park. This park is bursting with history. Some of the most historically significant and world-famous sites in Dover can be found here, including the Johnson Victrola Museum, John Bell House, Old State House, and many more fantastic places worth visiting. If you're looking for a good starting point to begin your journey in Dover, there's no better place to get your bearings than here. The Air Mobility Command Museum. We've come a long way since the Wright brothers made their first historic flight at Kitty Hawk, North Carolina, more than a century ago. It wasn't all that surprising how their groundbreaking invention was almost immediately adapted to serve a military purpose. At this museum, you can get an up-close and personal glimpse of some of the most fear-inspiring aircraft in the history of 20th and 21st century warfare. You'll get to witness the glory of aircraft bombers and fighter jets in a way you never expected. This fantastic museum showcases the most extensive collection of U.S. military cargo planes and tankers in the nation. The heavy bomber A-26C is one of their crown jewels, but this place is jam-packed full of some of the most impressive aircraft ever assembled. Where else can you see attack planes and jet fighters under the same roof? This museum's collection of rare and historically significant aircraft deserves at least a few hours of your time. Hey, if you're enjoying this video so far, be sure to give it a like and subscribe to Viewcation if you haven't already. And stick around for more of the best of Dover. Johnson Victrola Museum. As one of the most visited and highly acclaimed museums in the country, the Johnson Victrola Museum, named after the late great E.R. Johnson, has a phenomenal collection of talking machines that date back to the earliest days of audio engineering. There are phonographs bearing the world-famous Victrola name that hail back to the 1800s. A trip here will offer you a cultural experience that will enlighten you about the genesis and evolution of audio recording and reproduction that will undoubtedly leave you feeling grateful that humanity took this monumental technological leap. We wouldn't have the high-fidelity audio mediums that we have today if trailblazers like E.R. Johnson didn't first work so hard to take these first initial steps into the world of audio technological development. Dover Downs Casino. Are you feeling lucky? If so, consider spending an evening playing slots and table games at one of Dover's premier casinos. While you can also have a full-fledged vacation stay here as there's lodging available and plenty of other entertainment and relaxation options, a brief visit will also give you plenty to write home about. Dover Downs Casino is also impressive from an architectural standpoint, as both its exterior and interior are marvels of modern design and ingenuity. After working up an appetite, doubling down on red and pulling that old familiar slot machine lever, you can also enjoy a premium meal at one of the casino's various restaurants. Dover International Speedway. Get your motors running, because at this 135,000-seat racetrack, you'll experience an unparalleled racing experience. Built in 1969, this internationally revered racetrack is one of the most visited tourist destinations in the country. Part of its draw is its enormous mascot, endearingly dubbed Monster Mile. NASCAR, the sport with the second largest fan base, prominently featured here. And in recent years, the Speedway has undergone extensive revitalization and expansion efforts that have been called a monster makeover. John Dickinson Plantation. Named after American politician and lawyer John Dickinson, this plantation is open to the public and is one of the most architecturally interesting houses in its neighborhood. It features a large collection of galleries and exhibits. A few of its most noteworthy collections include its showcasing of Delaware-made spirits and wines, which gives viewers a behind-the-scenes look at how they're produced and preserved. You'll also get a history lesson of the struggles and heartbreak of American slave Emmeline Hawkins, which will no doubt leave you with a lot to think about. Legislative Hall. This brilliant example of neo-colonial architecture is where Dover's legislative branch of government was housed. It's a sight worth seeing, even if you have little interest in the history of local government. It's also a museum that gives the public a chance to see what the building itself holds while displaying portraits painted by renowned artist Thomas Sully and other influential creative minds of his time. If you want to see where Dover's former courtrooms and House of Legislature were held, don't pass on this excellent pit stop. Delaware Agricultural Museum and Village. Here you'll find a variety of exhibits that will give you an educational look at the history and modern implementation of agriculture in the state of Delaware. While seeing a collection of old rain barrels might not sound all that thrilling, it's actually fairly fascinating to see all the steps involved in bringing food from seed to table. You'll get to see the various technological advancements that Delaware pioneers have made when it comes to farming machinery and tools, as well as how the agricultural railroad played a part in feeding the local residents in times past. Biggs Museum of Art. Founded in 1993, the Sewell C. Biggs Museum of American Art displays one of the most extensive collections of American decorative and fine art in the state. The museum features an ever-changing lineup of exhibits that rotate throughout the year, so it's always best to check their website before planning your visit. Intimate galleries offer visitors an unexpectedly personal experience with the art pieces on display. The museum also proudly supports public art education while offering various programs aimed at both children and adults to develop and refine their art skills. Grab a bite to eat. Dover is a town that knows how to eat. If you're looking to get a taste of the local flavor, there are more than a few mouth-watering options that await you. Cool Springs Fish Bar and Restaurant on State Street serves up a wide array of surf and turf options, including their signature Crab Imperial. Restaurant 55, a few doors down, is the perfect family-friendly spot to grab a burger and fries. And if you're looking to sink your teeth into one of the finest slices of pizza on the Eastern Seaboard, check out Piazza Mia on South Red Haven Lane. Firefly Music Festival. Music lovers rejoice. This four-day music festival, which will be held in September in 2022, has been featuring big name and emerging live acts since its inception in 2012. Every year, over 100 bands and musical artists perform at the event across seven stages. The lineup features just about every genre of music you can think of, from funky jam bands to indie rock and even EDM. It's held at the Dover International Speedway, meaning you don't have to be a motorsports fan to get a chance to check out what this location all about. The expansive grounds include a marketplace, several dispersed camping areas, restaurants, and a multitude of bars to get your drink on. Spence's Bazaar. If you're a fan of colossal flea markets with a combination of outdoor and indoor vendors, this is the perfect place for you to stop and search for an antique or unique souvenir. The market features an excellent selection of Amish goods, clothing items, collectibles, and memorabilia and furniture. There are also stalls that sell locally grown fruits and vegetables and other food items. We recommend arriving early in the day as it can get a bit congested during peak hours. But if you're looking for a unique shopping experience, this is it. Now it's time to hear from you. Did we miss any of your favorites in Dover? Let us know in the comments section below. And before you go, make sure you give this video a like and subscribe to Viewcation if you haven't already. Click the bell icon to stay updated on all our latest content.